Here's the first question then. Pause, please, and have a go. What mass of sulfur dioxide is formed from 96 grams of sulfur trioxide? We begin by making an equivalence between what we're given information on sulfur trioxide, and what we're asked. In this case, we are asked information about sulfur dioxide. These twos are important in the balance equation. They indicate that 2 moles of sulfur trioxide will produce 2 moles of sulfur dioxide. If 2 is equivalent to 2, then 1 is equivalent to 1. This allows me to write that 1 mole of SO3 is equivalent to, or will produce, 1 mole of SO3. Let's work out the mass of 1 mole of each of these chemicals. First of all, SO3. That's got 1s, which is 32, and 3 oxygens, 3 16s, 48. That gives us a total of 80. 1 mole of this chemical is 80 grams. A mole of SO2 has got 1s, which contributes 32 to the relative molecular mass. 2 oxygens, 2 16s, 32. And that gives us a total of 64. So 1 mole of SO3 is 64 grams. Excuse me. SO2. And we have to work out what 96 grams would give. Let's work out what 1 gram of SO3 would give by way of SO2. I'm going to divide this by 80. That will give me 1 gram of SO3. What you do to one side, you must do to the other. So divide this by 80 as well. So 64 over 80. And that's grams of SO2. Now I can work out what 96 grams would produce. I'm going to multiply this by 96. That'll give me 96 grams of SO3. And what you do to one side, you do to the other. So again, I multiply this side by 96. That gives me 64 times 96 divided by 80 grams of SO2. Let's work that out. 64 times by 96. And divided by 80. That gives me 76.8. That's the answer.